request our guests to be please seated on the dais. Udin, Dr. A.K. Pandey, and Dr. Santosh Joshi. I take this opportunity to welcome our chief guest of the inaugural ceremony, Professor S.K. Ghosh, Dr. Peter Dikat, Dr. Wahabuddin, Dr. A.K. Pandey, and Dr. Santosh Joshi, and to extend a further word of welcome to my colleagues present here this morning. It is a pleasure to see many of you here. We have gathered here for the inaugural ceremony of the first BINA workshop being organized at Aryabhatta Research Institute of Observational Sciences during 15 to 18 November 2016. The light of knowledge. I request Professor S.K. Ghosh, Dr. Peter Dikat, Dr. Wahabuddin, Dr. A.K. Pandey, and Dr. Santosh Joshi to start the inauguration of BINA workshop with the lighting of the lamp, which has a deep intellectual and spiritual significance. Santosh Joshi, Ghosh, and Dr. Peter Dikat with the presentation of a shawl. And the arts, and prayers are offered to Goddess Saraswati for guidance and knowledge. I request our students to recite the Saraswati Vandana.
Thank you.
That was a very melodious recital by our students. Belgo Indian Network for Astronomy and Astrophysics, BINA, is a research network funded by Belgian Science Policy Office and Department of Science and Technology in order to foster scientific collaborations between Indian and Belgian astronomers. I request Dr. Wahabuddin to please deliver the welcome address.
A very good morning to all the participants from India and abroad in the first BINA workshop. It gives me great pleasure to extend my hearty warm welcome to all of you here on behalf of ARIES family in the inaugural function of this workshop. Belgo Indian Network for Astronomy and Astrophysics, which in brief called BINA, is a research network recently funded by BELSPO and DST, Government of India, in order to foster scientific collaboration between India and Belgium astronomers. The purpose of this workshop is to establish a collaboration to make a best use and carry out cutting-edge research of the new observing facilities, 3.6 meter Deustar optical telescope and upcoming 4 meter ILMT in collaboration with Belgium, located in Deustar, Nainital. During next 4 days, scientists and researchers from India and abroad would discuss about various frontline science goals and plan to achieve using these two observational facilities at Deustar, along with other frontline observing facilities in India and Belgium. Here, I would like to convey that Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Honorable Secretary DST, had planned his visit to inaugurate this BINA workshop, but unfortunately, due to some unavoidable circumstances, he could not attend the function. So on this auspicious occasion, he has conveyed his kind message, which I am conveying to all of you. The Belgo Indian Network for Astronomy and Astrophysics is a network of astronomers from different institutes of India and Belgium, financially supported by DST, Government of India, and BELSPO, Government of Belgium, for a period of 3 days. I am happy to know that participants from countries other than India, Belgium, are also attending this conference. The BINA program was initiated by India and Belgium scientists, keeping in mind the upcoming observational facilities at Deustar. The objective of this network is to address many mysteries of the cosmos, such as origin of galaxies, life cycles of stars, internal structure and evolution of stars, probing the powerful and elusive black holes, search for the first stars and galaxies in the universe, etc. The 3.6 meter dot and 4 meter ILMT will serve the international astronomy community for time-critical observations, those require 4-meter class observation optical telescopes to fill the large longitudinal gap in large optical observing facilities between Canary Islands and Eastern Australia. These two telescopes would become even more important for creating experienced and trained personnel for future large optical facilities, such as the 30-meter telescope, one of the mega projects where India is participating. I congratulate ARIES for their effort to establish such state-of-the-art facilities at Deustar. The BINA collaboration should be extended through the observation taken with other telescopes located in both the countries. by probing the complementary optical and near infrared observations of astronomical sources detected in radio wavelengths by joint meter wave radio telescope and in X-rays and UV by astrosat recently launched. The present workshop from 15 to 18 November 2016 at ARIES Nainital is first kind of activity to summarize and promote scientific collaborative project that will make the best use of new observing facilities at ARIES. The second BINA workshop is proposed at Belgium in 2017. Such meetings are perfect opportunity to allow face-to-face discussions during next few days among the participants of BINA workshop for the strengthening the ongoing collaboration and to start new collaboration. I am sure this workshop will give an opportunity to young scientists to interact with the international astronomers to develop frontline research programs as well as cutting-edge instruments for the 3.6 meter dot. I congratulate the organizers for their endeavors and wish BINA workshop a grand success. It is a right time to extend a big thanks to those who contributed extensively to make successful completion of 3.6 meter Devasthal optical telescope project. Due to limited time, it is very difficult to quote the name of all the persons who contributed significantly in the success of this project. Here I would like to thank especially to Professor Ram Sagar here, as Director ARIES, who initiated this mega project, 3.6 meter Devasthal optical telescope project. I would also like to thank to DST, who generously funded this mega project and extended their support continuously. I once again welcome you all in this workshop and hope that all of you will enjoy the beauty of this lake city, and we will make our effort to make your stay comfortable and memorable. We look forward to have a very productive and fruitful discussions among the scientists and researchers from various research institutes within the country and abroad during the next few days. So, thank you very much.
And also for the encouraging message from Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary, Department of Science and Technology. Dr. Peter Ricciat is the Belgian PI for the BINA network and holds the position of a scientist in Royal Observatory of Belgium in Brussels. His main scientific interests are astroseismology of main sequence gravity mode pulsators and spectroscopy and photometry of variable stars. He is also interested in astrometry of minor planets. I request Dr. Peter Ricciat to give an introduction of the BINA network.
Thank you very much. I prepared a small presentation to introduce the BINA network. But first of all, I would like to welcome all of you, and I'm very happy to see that there are so many people, both from Indian side and from international side, that are interested in this collaboration between Belgium and India. So when I, in this presentation, I wanted to introduce you the Belgian and Indian partners and what the objectives of this collaboration actually are. So I'm just waiting a little bit for the presentation coming up. But I can already start to say what I wanted to say. So in the beginning, we submitted this proposal in 2014, and at that time there were basically two Belgian institutes that were interested in this collaboration. At the one side, the Royal Observatory, and at the other side, the University of Liège. And at this point, I would also like to thank Professor Jean Surdesh, who is sitting here in front, who has been already active for many years to get the ELMT project started, and who invested already a lot of time in this collaboration with India. So I'll just continue, and in the meantime, some other Belgian institutes have also showed their interest. There are three other institutes. You have the University of Ghent, who will be presented here in this conference by Marjorie de Clair, who is sitting there. You also have the University of Leuven and the University of Antwerp, who will be presented by Katrien Kolenberg. And I'm forgetting one at the moment. Yes, and the Free University of Brussels, who is presented today by Drisha, who is also sitting somewhere there in the back. So, and from the Indian side, there are seven institutes. I don't know all them. This was the presentation. So this is the map of Belgium, where you can see where all these Belgian institutes are located. And this is the list of all the Indian institutes that are within the BINA project. So I also want to mention that from the Belgian side, I am the PI, and from the Indian side, Dr. Santosh Joshi is the PI of the project. So the location of these institutes are all over India, as you can see on the map. And Santosh made a nice... Oh. It doesn't work anymore. These are also connected by lines to the PI Institute, and both are connected as if they were a binary. So that's to symbolize the collaboration. So the objectives of this collaboration is all focused around what can be done at the Observatory of De Vastel. So at the one hand, you have the 3.6 dot telescope. Belgium has some guaranteed observation time on that telescope because BELSPO invested 2 million euros in the construction of it. So at the moment when we were introducing the proposal, there were two instruments that were proposed at that time. First of all, there was a three-channel fast CCD photometer, which is similar to the MAYA instrument on the Mercator telescope in La Palma, that is being led by the Leuven University. And on the other hand, there was also a high-resolution spectrograph that was being developed, which is similar to the Hermes telescope. At this moment, there are three instruments that will be offered on this telescope. First, an optical imager with some photometric filters, and then FOSC, which will operate between 350 and 900 nanometers, also with some broadband filters and narrow filters and some prism, so you can also do some low resolution spectroscopy, and TIRCAM, which will operate in the near infrared. So the other telescope is the 4-meter International Liquid Mirror Telescope that has been developed thanks to Jean Surdesch. It has a rotating container with mercury, which is actually the mirror of the telescope, and in that sense it's a very unique instrument in the world. And it will monitor a small strip of 0.5 degrees around 29.4 declination continuously. So the objectives of this collaboration is that we want to do an efficient scientific exploitation of the observations of solar system objects and objects, galactic and extragalactic celestial objects. And with this collaboration, we also want to have an optimal development and commissioning of the new instruments. And we want a shared approach for the preparation of the observation proposals, also for procedures of data acquisition, data reduction, and the backup of the data. And this is all centralized around scientific goals of common interest, which are listed there, which is a large number. So what can be funded with this project are network activities. So with this network, we can fund two workshops. One is the one that we are organizing here in Nainital, so which will basically be centered around the instrumentation and the already ongoing and new collaborations. And next one will be observed in Belgium, normally in 2017, where we want to discuss the first scientific results. And we also have some funding for working visits from India to Belgium and from Belgium to India. So this workshop is the first workshop that has been organized within this collaboration. So this is also the official start of this collaboration. So I hope it will be very fruitful, and I hope that we can look forward to a very long collaboration between India and Belgium. So that's what I wanted to say. Thank you.
Dr. Peter, for briefing us about the BINA network. Dr. A.K. Pandey is a senior scientist at ARIES and is the chairman of the scientific organizing committee of the first BINA workshop. I request Dr. Pandey to brief us about the highlights of the scientific program during the workshop.
Good morning. Welcome to all the participants from Belgium and some more other countries like Japan, Taiwan, Thailand, etc. I feel privileged to welcome all the participants for this first BINA workshop, which objectives of which has been described by Peter. And the theme is science and instrumentation with the 3.6 meter Devastal optical telescope. In brief, we say it DOT, and the 4 meter International Liquid Mirror Telescope. The 3.6 meter DOT has already been technically activated by Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Modi, and Honorable Prime Minister of Belgium, Mr. Charles Michel, on 30th March of this year. We also expect that the 4 meter Liquid Mirror Telescope will be operational by April next year. We got a very, very overwhelming response to our call for expression of interest for participation in this conference. Initially, keeping the facilities available at ARIES campus, Nainital campus, we put a limit of about 60 participants, but we got more than 150 expression of interest with very, very interesting and exciting contributions related to the scientific theme and contents of the conference. It was really a very difficult task for the SOC to select only 50 or 60 contributions out of more than 151. Hence, SOC requested to increase the limit of participants. We are thankful to the LOC for making arrangement for about 100 participants. I am thankful to all the SOC members for their active participation in deciding the scientific program of the conference, which contains 36 talks and 45 poster presentations. We also feel very sorry for those who have shown their interest, but we are not able to invite them because of our resource limitations. Since we do not have facilities to accommodate all the participants in ARIES campus, we requested the director of Administrative Training Institute, ATI, to allow us to use the ATI facilities. We are thankful to the ATI for being kind enough to allow us to use this scenic and serene place for the conference. I'm sure participants will enjoy the ambience of ATI, which will definitely inspire them for several stimulating discussions. The objective of this conference are to address, as discussed by Peter, to address research topics in solar system as well as detailed studies of galactic and extragalactic celestial objects using observations with 3.6 meter dot and 4 meter ILMT at Devastar. I'm sure that this conference will provide an opportunity to stimulate close interaction between Indians, especially the young ones, and scientists from abroad working in the areas of star formation, star clusters, astroseismology, binaries, massive stars, abundance studies, galaxies, active galactic nuclei, quasars, gravitational lensing systems, just to name a few, and ground-based support for space missions such as AstroSat and others. Access to the 4-meter class telescope for Indian astronomer will provide an opportunity not only to develop frontline research programs in international collaboration, but also to generate new ideas to design modern back-end instruments to carry out cutting-edge science with these telescopes. We are thankful to all those persons who expressed their interest in conference and to all the participants, which are from Belgium, Japan, Taiwan, Thailand, Russia, South Africa, and India, and who are present here to make this conference a big success. We are thankful to the Department of Science and Technology, DST, and Belgian Science Policy Office, BELSO, for providing the grants. The SOC is thankful to the LOC and all ARIES staff members for their help to make this conference a big success. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey, for providing a preview of the upcoming scientific talks during the workshop. I extend our welcome to the print and electronic media who support us and provide a platform to present the activities of ARIES both at national and international levels. We are honored to have Professor S.K. Ghosh, who is the Center Director of National Center for Radio Astrophysics, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, located in Pune, India. Professor Ghosh's primary research interest lies in the interstellar medium, especially star-forming regions, IR astronomy, and in astronomical instrumentation. Professor Ghosh is involved with the ultraviolet imaging telescope on board the Indian multi-wavelength mission AstroSat, which has successfully completed 1 year in orbit. He is also involved with various other infrared imagers and spectrometers, both for ground-based telescopes and those targeted for small satellite mission of ISRO. I request our chief guest of the inaugural ceremony of the first BINA workshop, Professor S.K. Ghosh, to brief us about the international collaborations with Indian facilities. Professor Ghosh, please.
Yesterday evening, I was told that I'm to give us the keynote address to. I was going to talk about collaborations anyway. So I will be sharing some thoughts on that, given the occasion today. And keynote, of course, has the word note, which kind of excites or brings tensions to people's mind in India today. But it has nothing to do with that note, of course. So, jokes apart. Firstly, there is a typo in here. It should be 18th November, as I understand. I thought it is only up to 17th. Yeah. So I'll talk about a few thoughts. Some of them inspired by, incidentally, a long discussion with Professor Gopal Krishna on the way to this place yesterday. Anyway. So I've just quoted what is the charter of BINA. Everybody knows. I'm not going to say anything new actually. I'm just restating what all of us have been thinking about, talked about. So BINA's purpose is to make best use of the new 3.6 meter DOT and 4 meter ILMT. So what does it mean? Let us consider this phrase, best use. Actually, the issue is for any facility, not necessarily this. This is a new facility, but one could revisit for any facility, similar facility in principle. So perhaps one should be clear about what is meant by best use. But different people may have different perspective on that. So one could go on. Does it mean minimum downtime for the facility, like telescope, like 90% plus? Or it's a good measure to say whether the facility is running well or not. Certainly, it's a tall order, and people who manage facilities do consider this as one of the major index which reflects on the efficiency with which the facility has been made available to end users. It's certainly important, but it reflects on basically people whose primary responsibility is doing it. One could also say what fraction of the uptime has been used for making measurements. That's another different index, which could imply how well the time allocation committee or whoever decides that how the machine is to be used has been appropriately directed and meaningful measurements have been carried out. They are all dissimilar things, but they all contribute to what might be called best use. More importantly, how these measurements are translated to their so-called logical conclusion. I'm sure nobody would argue about what is that logical conclusion. Obviously, it should be astrophysical results. About that, there may not be any debate. So, one has to go through all this. But there is more to it. You can have astrophysical results, but finally what counts eventually internationally is that what is the significance of those results. And I think one has to start thinking on those. Other things are kind of a given that will happen. There will be mechanisms to make sure other things happen. If something is not happening, I am sure people know how to go about doing that. Now, making significant results is a kind of very challenging and difficult task. Because it is known in any branch of experimental physics that more challenging, more interesting is the problem, that much harder is the competition internationally. Goes without saying. I'm not saying anything new. You all know it. Now, what one does in a situation where there is a tough competition, obviously one has to optimize one's method of competitive, what is one's own competitiveness. How does one go about doing it? So here is a recipe. One could debate on that. One could start by identifying what are the kind of skill set one has, and then also explore with potential collaborators skill sets, and then join hands where there is a complementarity in the skills. Again, this is very common sense, but I am just restating to say that it's very important to look in those terms. And if you, there may be areas where there are some weaknesses, and one should basically address those problems, because it is better left to better people. But where we have a strength, certainly do exploit. So this BINA, as we saw, this is one enabling method where one could look for possible scientific collaboration for instrumentation as well as science. And then there are, you know, DST funded bilateral, I have put XYZ for the name of the other country, So there are resources available under these to certainly make things happen by exploring, finding each other's recognizing skills. But there is one more point. There is a large community of astronomers within India also. And I personally feel there is a scope for increasing collaborations within different segments with different skill, complementary skill sets. One should go maybe multi-wavelength also, one skill maybe in some particular waveband channel, but one could immediately address much harder astrophysical problems or make a bigger impact by making a multi-wavelength pitch. Now in that sense, one could add that particularly for transient kind of activities in this multi-wavelength within Indian system, now that we have BOT here and then there is a astrosat in orbit, GMRT is there, so there could be things where by coordinating these observations in these observatories, by managing the transient phenomena by allocating telescope times, one could address something which we may have an advantage over other competitors. So I'm giving my personal view on these, but certainly it's worth thinking there may be other better ways of doing this. Yeah, now coming to the international collaboration, of course, let's continue on the same theme. So, yeah, I have already said about this. So certainly this DOT is a very powerful facility in the for Asian region, itself, not just India. And it is enabling optical and near-infrared astronomers. So I will give my personal bias. With my personal bias, I will give some examples of how these collaborations have, in the past, in Indian context, has helped doing something meaty, which has led to something useful. But I'm sure there will be other examples, and I know there are people in audience, for example, Professor Ram Prakash, who would have other examples to give. But I will just give, for today's purpose, some example and move on. So this was, you know, GMRT has been there. And then a small collaboration between Canada and India led to moving from the legacy hardware backend, which is the actual correlator system of the GMRT, which was moved to a software backend. Now, it was done in 2010, and it has really improved the efficiency and many other things of the GMRT. And of course, right now we have things beyond that, but this is just one example. This is a picture of how it looks. Moving to software means you will have these racks of computers, and then main intellectual input is in the coding and other things. Okay, another example. So it's somewhat older, although still work continues in that. So we have a balloon-borne 1 meter telescope, which was built by TIFR, but so this is an example of an Indo-Japanese collaboration where JSPS and DST had supported partly. And so the back end of that telescope, which was, so this is the kind of telescope. This is like an observatory, 1 meter telescope observatory, which flies above Earth's atmosphere and does measurements in far infrared astronomy. But so at the back end, there was this kind of 0.3 degree Kelvin cooled bolometer array, which was kind of doing far infrared photometric imaging, which was replaced by spectrometer. It was quite high medium resolution and state of the art of that point of time. So these are kind of examples. Now coming back, of course, there are many, many multi-country collaborations now funded through the Department of Science and Technology and the Department of Atomic Energy. And some examples are listed here. A square kilometer array in radio astronomy context and 30 meter telescope in optical infrared context. And there are multiple institutes in the country who are involved in doing that. So international collaboration is anyway happening, and so these were all examples of capability building or instrumentation. Of course, scientific collaboration are so numerous and has been from so long time, there's no need to go into that today just now, but I'm sure that is also actually more important eventually after the instruments are there. And there is institutional governmental support, funding is available, and I hope that people will make sure that how best one can make use of those enabling things and do quality science. That's all right. Thank you.
Professor Ghosh for letting us know about the international and national collaborations that will be coming up in the future. The first BINA workshop wouldn't have been possible without the tireless effort of the BINA India PI, Dr. Santosh Joshi. Dr. Santosh Joshi is also the coordinator of the local organizing committee. I request Dr. Santosh Joshi to present the vote of thanks.
Namaskar. A very good morning, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to extend a vote of thanks on this historic occasion. We are delighted to host the first BINA conference at Nainital. On this occasion, I, on behalf of the organizing committee, convey deep regards and hearty thanks to the Secretary, Ministry of Science and Technology, Government of India, Professor Ashutosh Sharma ji, who had accepted our invitation to inaugurate this function, but unfortunately, due to some sudden urgent requirements, he is unable to attend this session. However, we are greatly encouraged by his inspiring message. I am very grateful to the sponsoring agency of this event, namely DST, Department of Science and Technology, DST, Government of India, Belgian Federal Science Policy Office, BELESPO, Government of Belgium, and the host institute, ARIES, Nainital. Without the generous financial support from these bodies, it would not have been possible to organize this conference. I wish to express my gratitude to Professor S.K. Ghosh ji for his gracious presence in presenting the scientific collaboration with Indian facilities. It is my great pleasure to express a deep appreciation to Dr. S.K. Vasney ji, Advisor, International Bilateral Cooperation, DST Government of India, for his meticulous guidance and support to host the first BINA workshop in India. My deep regards and thanks to all the associate members, chaired by Dr. Anil Kumar Pandey, who shared valuable insight by devoting their precious time to finalize the scientific content and program of this workshop. An event of such high magnitude cannot happen overnight. It requires detailed planning and execution. We are fortunate to have a dedicated and motivated team of local organizing committee and entire staff led by Dr. Bahabuddin ji for their unlimited support and encouragement. They all work cheerfully towards making this seminar successful. It wouldn't be possible to name every individual here, but I appreciate the support received from Registrar ARIES, Sri Ravin Kumarji, Bharatji, Praveen Solankiji, Hansa, Anand Singh, Rajiv, Abhishek, Arjun, Prashant, Pradeep, Mahesh, Adi Joshiji, Ravinji, Harish Tiwari ji, V.K. Singh, Kanwal ji, Ramdayal Bhatt, and Basant Ballabhar ji. It would be not fair if I do not acknowledge the support received from my friends Ramakant, Sashi, Jeevan, Kuntal, Umesh, Naren, Sneh, Humchan, Vijesh, Yogesh, Saurabh, Maheshwar, and other faculties of ARIES for helping throughout. I convey thanks to all the distinguished participants who have come from far distance to attend this conference. Though BINA is a network of the scientists from India and Belgium, but the astronomers from other countries, Russia, China, South Africa, Japan, Thailand, Taiwan are also present here. This reflects their interest to utilize the new observing facility at Devasthal. I also extend my thanks to all the speakers presenting recent results obtained by them and exchanging their thoughts and ideas to enhance one another's knowledge. My warm appreciation goes to Peter Dickett, PI from Belgium, and other co-investigators from India and Belgium for accepting our invitation to be part of this bilateral program. Here I would like to take an opportunity to thank Director ATI, Sri Avinendra Nayal ji, for providing excellent logistic facilities. I thank Deputy Director Sri Jagdish Kantpal ji, Program Coordinator Sri Anand Kumar ji, as well as whole ATI administration for their kind support. My sincere thanks is due for the print and electronic media for their presence and providing wide coverage of this international workshop. Before concluding, I thank all the delegates for their gracious presence. I am assured that the BINA network would join hands towards making this collaboration more wider, dynamic, and sensitive to achieve the objective of the mission. I wish all the participants have a very fruitful and productive scientific session. A big dhanyavaad. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Santosh Joshi. Two important announcements. The Wi-Fi network in the auditorium is named as Gangotri 2 with capital G. And the password for the network is ATIA@GANG, G-A-N-G. It will be shortly displayed over here, so you won't have any problem in getting connected to the internet. We extend our gratitude and thanks to all who have made the first BINA workshop possible. This inaugural ceremony marks the commencement of the first BINA workshop. You are most welcome to stay during the workshop, and I hope you enjoy the scientific highlights during the meeting. I wish you a pleasant stay in the picturesque surroundings of the beautiful hill station Nainital. We break here for high tea, which is arranged outside, and we reconvene again at 11:30 a.m. for the first scientific session of this workshop. Thank you.
नैनीताल के देवस्थल में 4 मीटर के लिक्विड मिरर टेलीस्कोप को स्थापित किया जाएगा, जिसके लिए वैज्ञानिकों ने योजना भी तैयार कर ली है। इससे पहले इस जगह पर इसी साल 3.6 मीटर की दूरबीन स्थापित की थी, जिसके जरिए ब्रह्मांड के रहस्यों पर शोध किया जा रहा है।
अंतरिक्ष अनंत अतः और गूण रहस्यों से भरा पड़ा है। ब्रह्मांड के कई रहस्यों तक इंसान ने सफलतापूर्वक दस्तक दे दी है, लेकिन अभी भी ब्रह्मांड के कई पहलू अनछुए हैं। अंतरिक्ष के इन्हीं गूण रहस्यों को समझने के लिए वैज्ञानिकों ने पहल शुरू कर दी है।
इससे क्या साइंस हो सकती है? 3.6 मीटर एशिया की सबसे बड़ी दूरबीन है, तो हमने एक स्टेप लिया कि हम बेल्जियम और इंडिया के वैज्ञानिकों को एक साथ इकट्ठा करके इस विषय पर चर्चा करें कि इस 3.6 मीटर और 4.0 मीटर इंटरनेशनल लिक्विड मिरर टेलीस्कोप का कैसे बेस्ट यूटिलाइजेशन किया जाए।
इसी साल मार्च में नैनीताल के देवस्थल में एशिया की सबसे बड़ी 3.6 मीटर व्यास की दूरबीन स्थापित की गई, जिसके बाद से एरीज यानी आर्यभट्ट प्रेक्ष शोध संस्थान ने सफलता की ओर एक और कदम बढ़ा दिया है। भारत और बेल्जियम की साझा परियोजना के तहत लगभग 5 करोड़ की लागत से नैनीताल के देवस्थल में ही विश्व की पहली 4 मीटर लिक्विड मिरर टेलीस्कोप स्थापित होने जा रही है। देवस्थल में इसका काम भी शुरू हो चुका है और उम्मीद की जा रही है कि आने वाले अप्रैल तक ये दूरबीन अंतरिक्ष में विशेषकर तारों के ऑब्जर्वेशन में अपना योगदान देना शुरू कर देगी।
ये टेलीस्कोप जो है एक नॉन कन्वेंशनल की टाइप की टेलीस्कोप है। इसमें जो मिरर है वो एक मरकरी को हम यूज करते हैं। इसमें एक रोटेटिंग बाउल होगा जो कि और उसमें एक मरकरी होगा और जो वो मरकरी उसके सरफेस में रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस का काम करेगा यानी मिरर का काम करेगा। इस दूरबीन में एक खासियत यह है कि एक तो ये बहुत सस्ती है रिलेटिवली जो हमारी कन्वेंशनल दूरबीन है 3.6 मीटर दूरबीन है उसके मुकाबले ये करीब 1/20th कम पड़ेगी। और अभी शुरुआत के स्टेज में ये 5 साल का प्रोजेक्ट है और इस 5 साल के 5 साल में अब 100 ऑफ मिलियंस ऑफ स्टार इसमें ऑब्जर्व करेंगे। खासतौर पे युवा जनरेशन को ये एक नए फील्ड में काम करने के लिए प्रोत्साहित करेगी।
इस मिरर टेलीस्कोप की सबसे बड़ी खासियत है कि ये एक तो बहुत कम बजट पर स्थापित हो रही है और दूसरा ये अंतरिक्ष के टॉप मोस्ट पॉइंट को देखेगी और पूरी रात ऑब्जर्व करेगी। 5 साल के इस प्रोजेक्ट में ये टेलीस्कोप 100 मिलियन स्टार्स को ऑब्जर्व करेगी जिससे स्टार्स की स्टडी में काफी मदद मिलेगी। इसी के साथ भारत और बेल्जियम की साझेदारी के साथ ही एरीज को दुनिया में नया आयाम मिलेगा। मिरर दूरबीन को सीमित आकाशीय क्षेत्र में लंबे वक्त तक अध्ययन के लिए इस्तेमाल में लाया जाता है। लेंस में मरकरी धातु का इस्तेमाल होने से ये मिरर की तरह काम करता है। इससे टकराकर लौटने वाले प्रकाश को कैमरे में कैद कर अध्ययन किया जाता है, इसलिए इसे लिक्विड मिरर दूरबीन कहा जाता है। और इसी को लेकर वैज्ञानिक कैसे साइंस और टेक्नोलॉजी का बेहतर इस्तेमाल करें, कैसे इसका उपयोग करें और कैसे विश्व भर के वैज्ञानिक अपने ज्ञान का आदान प्रदान करें, इसको लेकर नैनीताल में वैज्ञानिक मंथन में जुटे हैं। नैनीताल के एटीआई में आयोजित इस सेमिनार में भारत और बेल्जियम के अलावा रशिया, चाइना, जापान, थाईलैंड और ताइवान के वैज्ञानिक भाग ले रहे हैं जो इस बात पर चर्चा कर रहे हैं कि कैसे 4.0 मीटर इंटरनेशनल लिक्विड मिरर टेलीस्कोप का बेहतर उपयोग किया जा सकता है। इस मिरर टेलीस्कोप परियोजना को बेल्गो इंडियन नेटवर्क फॉर एस्ट्रोनॉमी एंड एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स प्रोजेक्ट के तहत मंजूरी मिली है जिसका मॉडल तैयार हो चुका है और इस बार भी बेल्जियम की एमोस ने ये टेलीस्कोप बनाई है जिसमें एरीज की भी भागीदारी है। ये लिक्विड मिरर दूरबीन स्थापित होने के बाद बेस्ट डेटा सैंपल देगी। नैनीताल के देवस्थल में स्थापित होने जा रही ये लिक्विड मिरर टेलीस्कोप दुनिया की इकलौती टेलीस्कोप है जो भारत और बेल्जियम की साझेदारी को नए आयाम देगी। नैनीताल से राजू पांडे के साथ ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया 24/7।